Hi friends. Again, my name is Dhanraj Kidiur from the company PWIP. In the past as well, we have spoken about rice and how. I'm so sorry, my friends. My kid is around. So we have spoken about rice as to last time we also spoke about payment terms in exports. We spoke about rice to identify rice. Say, we spoke about RNR, HMT, and Kolam rice. Today, very specifically, my friends, I'm going to advise you as to how you can buy rice at a lower price. There is no rocket science, but there are some things that you can keep in mind to buy rice at lower price. Now, there is mainly three things that you have to keep in mind while buying rice. Point number one is moisture content in rice. Two is broken percentage in rice, and three is finance. Right? I'll tell you how you can use these three tools to get your rice price lower. Point number one, as I said, moisture. Now, say for example, if you are buying Sona Masuri rice, or if you are buying, say, what do you call IR64 rice, or you're buying BPT or basmati. Now, majorly, when a miller mills the rice, he dries the paddy based on either, say, for example, around 9 or 9.5% moisture. That is when a rice has to look whiter and creamy and whiter and nice. He'll have to mill the rice at about 9.5% moisture, right? If you want a white looking rice. But if he increases the moisture from 9.5 to 10% to 11% to 12%, the prices can go down up to about another 1 rupee, or in foreign transactions the price can go down to about $15 per ton. Now, how to do this, I'll tell you, right? So when a moisture is dried at 9.5% moisture, for example, where the miller is trying to achieve a whiter finish of the rice, the broken percentage will increase for him because the rice will break when it is treated with high dryness to dry the moisture at 9.5%. So the lot of grains will break. And then, so very naturally, he will increase the price. The miller will increase the price of the rice because he has to compensate for that broken rice, right? So, 9.5% moisture rice will look very creamy and white in color, whereas 12% moisture rice, will look very creamy, like a oil finish and creamy in color, right? Because at high moisture, at 12% moisture, that is how a rice will look, very creamy and like a oily finish. Now, normally when you buy rice, say from Karnataka region, Sona Masuri rice, this is rough about, say, I would say it is about 10% to 11% is the moisture of the rice. Remember, friends, I am talking about the moisture when the of paddy, how the what at what moisture the paddy is dried. I am not talking about the moisture of the milled rice. The milled rice, for example, normally the moisture is around 12%, 13%, and maximum 14%. Never buy a rice which has moisture more than 14% because you will have two problems. One is that the cooking will not be good. You will face customer complaints. Cooking quality will be very bad in a 14 more than 14% moisture. And the second most advantages of a rice which is having moisture more than 14% is that when you ship these goods, when you transport these goods, and when you stock it, and when you use it later in a month or so, the bug formation in the rice, or the rice getting the fungus that can attract to the rice, the chances are much higher. In a rice which has moisture which is more than 14%, right? So normally I will say, for example, if you are buying Sona Masuri from, say, Tumkur region, Bellary and Raichur region, they are very much used to keeping the moisture of rice at about 10% to 11%, or maximum 11.5 to 12%, not more than 12. So this is how they are very used to it. If you go to Telangana, Miryal Guda regions, also not the moisture will not go beyond 12%. But if you go to say Gondia, Amgaon, Warsa, Nagpur, these kind of regions for steam rice, you know, and parboiled rice, the moisture will go up to about 13 to 14%. But below 14% is what you will notice the rice. Even if it is say raw or steam or parboiled rice, this is what the moisture is. The moisture has to be always below 14%. Now, what am I going to tell you is that why and how can you, you know, work around the moisture to bring your pricing down. This you will have to do for understanding from the customer. So if the customer says that I am okay with the cream quality, for me the cooking has to be good, then you can tell the miller, why don't you mill the paddy at about 12% moisture to 13% moisture, right? So then the rice will look creamy in color. Then the you can save some money. So for example you're talking to a miller in Raichur in Karnataka, and you know that the miller is milling the rice at 10% moisture, the paddy, he's drying the paddy at 10% moisture, and he has quoted you 2900 for the rice per kg, right? 29 rupees he's quoted, and you know that he's drying at 10% moisture. Now if your customer is okay with the creamy rice, you can tell him you can mill the rice at 12% moisture, and your 2900 pricing can come to 2800. So this is the how do you play with the moisture. Always check, my friends, in moisture you have to check two things. One is the moisture of the paddy, and the other thing is the moisture of the rice, right? Here I am talking about the moisture of the paddy in which the paddy is dry. So let's take two numbers, 9.5% moisture, 12% moisture. 9.5% moisture, if the rice rate is 2900, the miller is quoting, you ask him for a 12% moisture rice, the price will automatically become 2800, because at that moisture the broken percentage will reduce. So he can reduce his expenses and offer that benefit to you. Many millers, all the millers know this, so they can help you out with this. Right, so we covered the moisture part. Now the second thing is to consider the broken percentage, right? So whenever you are buying rice, do you actually know what is the broken percentage that is there in the rice? This broken percentage can vary from 1% to 2% to 5% or 10% or to 20%, whichever way you are buying the rice and whatever quality that you are buying. I'll give you an example. Normally the rice that you buy from say Tumkur, Raichur, Bellari, Telangana, or even for that say Nellore in Andhra Pradesh, the broken percentage in this rice is hardly 1% or 2%, even less than 2%. Less than 2% means what? Your rice is 98% and the brokens are 2% in your rice. Which means you can hardly make out, when you take the rice in your hands, you can hardly make out that there is any brokens in it. The grains are naturally to be broken. They in shipment, in transit, also the rice will lead to some breakage, but very minimum. But 1 to 2% is the max. But let's say if you go to Nagpur region or Raipur in Chhattisgarh, where the major rice profiles are IR64 rice, raw, parboiled, swarna. There when you go to buy rice, the broken percentage becomes a very important thing to discuss, because prices vary from 5% broken to 10% broken, 15% broken, 25% broken, you know, so on. So what happens is when you're in Nagpur region or in Chhattisgarh region, we're buying Swarna rice and IR64 rice, if you say 5%, for example, you can go to PWIP, the mobile number on WhatsApp, where you can find out the prices. You just have to type in hi message to that WhatsApp to get your rice prices. So if you see Swarna rice prices and if you see IR64 rice prices there, so you can see that IR64, for example, the price, today's MX mill price is 22.30, right? So if you are buying that is for 5% broken IR64, if you are buying 10% broken, then your price will reduce by 20 paisa. if instead of 20 to 30, your price will become 22.1 rupees per kg. So, and if you further are buying 15% broken, again your price will reduce by 20 paisa per kg. So, or 20 rupees per quintal. So, this is how it is. As the broken increases in the rice, the price has to come down. So, I am not telling you that, you know, that is a way to actually manipulate or cheat a customer. No, this is a way to educate a customer. Tell him, tell your customer, he will like when you tell him the truth. Any customer, tell him that from Raichur, Tumkur or Bellary, the rice that we normally buy is about 1% or 2% moisture. But if you buy, if we increase this moisture percentage from 1 to 2% to 10% or say 15%, you can bring down the price by another 1 rupee per kg. So this is the advantage that you will get, which you can use to tell your customer. Because say for example, your customer is into catering business. Your customer is into a bulk cooking business where he supplies to, say, you know, workers' dormitory or you know, high scale, high volume functions where, you know, the rice quality has to be not top quality but decently good quality. So you can strategically buy from working around the broken percentage. Remember friends, the rice that you buy from Karnataka region, Telangana region, Andhra region are all broken percentages from 1% to 2%. In Nagpur and Chhattisgarh, if you're buying IR64 and Swarna, the broken percentage is ranging to up to 5%. Then if you buy 10%, again, price will reduce by 20 rupees. If you buy 15%, again, the price will reduce by another 20 rupees and so on, right? So by having that broken percentage, play, you can go and reduce the price. Sometimes if you really understand your customer, he or she might not want 100% rice. He or she might tell you that just give me 10% broken or 15% broken, I'm using it for catering purpose and for them it is okay, I can manage with that, right? So these are the 2 points, my friends. We have covered moisture content in rice, we have covered broken percentage in rice. And the last one, which is the third point, is very important, which is F for finance. So how you can use money and you can use finance to bring down your price. It is something like this. Normally, if you are into this rice business, you're new into this rice business and you just started talking to some rice agents or rice millers, they don't know you well, right? So they are not going to give you credit. They will say that you may first make the payment and then I am going to release the truck, right? So in these kind of a situations, you should definitely know how to bargain for better deals. Because in the majority of rice trade in India, the majority of transactions happen on credit, where an agent or a mill knows a party very well and they are doing business from long, and then they say that I am going to give you credit, you can give it to me after 15 days, 20 days. This is how it happens, right? So in every regions, majority of the regions, there is something called as cash discount that is available. Meaning if you are buying at 2900, right? So there is, in Raichur for example, there is a cash discount of from 2 to 4%. In Telangana, for example, there is a cash discount of again 2 to 4%. There is naturally, there is a cash discount of 1% across. Meaning, if I am buying today and I am going to pay next in 3-4 days, I am going to make the payment, then any miller will agree for 1% cash discount. So, if you can just reduce 1% in a bill and you can make the payment. Likewise, in Muktsar in Punjab, if you go, there is a system of 2.5% cash discount. Now, what is this cash discount? I will tell you. So, I have my calculator here. So, I'm going to demonstrate to you. Now, for example, if a miller in, say, Raichur has told you that, he's quoted you 29 rupees. So, and the cash discount is about 4%, right? So, 29 minus 4% is 27.84, right? So what you were planning to buy at 29 rupees, you can now buy it at 27.84 because you are going to give payment on at the time of loading, right? Now there is another point. Apart from cash discount, there is also one more point that you should note, which is that in the whole of in the business scenario in India, what happens is lot of millers are always looking for faster incoming payments, so which can help them, you know, to meet their buying requirements of paddy or maintaining their expenses. So everywhere in the business, people are, if a customer pays makes a payment much earlier than expected, anybody could like, right? You a trader ho ya, you know, miller ho ya koi bhi importer ho exporter ho koi bhi ho, jab payment jaldi aa jata hai to sabko bahut acha lagta hai. But जब आप बोलोगे कि यू नो आपने रेट 2900 कोट किया है, लेकिन मैं आपको ऑन लोडिंग पे पेमेंट दूंगा, मुझे 2700 में चाहिए, तो बहुत सारे मिलर्स है जो आपके लिए वो यस बोलेंगे. क्योंकि यू नो व्हेन इंस्टेड ऑफ वेटिंग फॉर 15 डेज व्हेन पेमेंट इज कमिंग 15 डेज अर्ली, एनी मिलर और मोस्ट ऑफ द मिलर्स will agree to your pricing price point. If around 100 to 200 rupees per quintal, they will definitely get it down, because that funds can help him for a lot of other expenses that he has, where he gets his lot of payments earlier. So this is how it is, my friends. So be it in Muktsar, be it in Muktsar Punjab, in Karnal in Haryana, Karnataka, Andhra, Tamil Nadu, anywhere the rice pockets that you are buying rice from, you just have to, you know, if you are having a payment in hand, you know, you can always, get a better price. I'm not talking about only cash discount. If the cash discount is 4%, you can ask for, say, for example, 7%, or anything that a miller is comfortable, he will work with you, and he would be happy to work with you when there is payment which is paid at the time of loading, right? Very importantly, friends, the reason I did this topic is because first thing in this rice business, if you have to grow in your rice business, you have to know your product first. Lot of times we talk to customer, customers come and say that I want to buy Sona Masuri, for example. But if we ask them what is Sona Masuri, what is raw, steam, parboiled, lot of them don't know that there is raw, steam and parboiled. You know, they get a bit little confused, then they say, okay, I have to ask my customer and come back to you. Then for example, even in broken, 100% broken rice, when you are going to buy a 100% broken rice, again, you know, when you say broken can be of steam, broken can be of raw, broken can be of parboiled. Parboiled is a little less, but take an example of steam and broken. So when you take when you buy brokens, what happens is, today for example, in today's day, broken 100% broken rice of steam from Raichur and Siriguppa region of Sona Masuri steam, you can buy it at around 15.50 to 16 rupees per kg, right? Whereas if you are buying the same raw rice, right? In raw rice, it is better that I suggest you have two options in raw rice broken. You can buy either Sona Masuri raw broken, or you can buy IR64 raw broken, or Swarna raw broken. Sona Masuri raw broken is from Raichur, Karnataka, Tumkur, Bellary, this region. IR64 broken and Swarna broken is from either from Kolkata, Burdwan in Kolkata, Raipur in Raipur, Chhattisgarh, or Gondia in Nagpur, right? So, but look at the cost difference. 21 rupees is for raw broken of Sona Masuri roughly in Karnataka, 21 rupees, whereas this is 17.6 rupees, right? Or even if say 18 rupees, you're still saving 3 rupees per kg. But quality difference is there. That is, in Sona Masuri raw, the quality is a very premium quality, whereas IR64 and Swarna is a little bit thicker grain and not a good great quality as Sona Masuri raw. That is why there's a difference in price. But if, what is your application? Why are you buying it for? Are you buying it for, say, for poultry feed, or say you're buying for dosa making requirement, or you're buying for shops which needs for this dosa or idli making requirements. So if the quality requirement is not of the highest quality, IR64 broken, you know, is also a very good option. If your customers are you know, into low quality cooking, where they want cheaper rice, you can definitely go for the brokens of you know, IR64 and Swarna. But where do you get to find this rice? How do you understand this price? You know, you and I, we know that this price of rice keeps on changing, right? You know, it keeps on changing. It keeps, it might be today the price might be after 2 days or 3 days. It is not the same, right? So, you know, how do you track this price? That is a very simple option, my friends. As I'm here is my phone. I'm going to take my phone and show you as to how to study rice. Which very simple. There is a number that you have to note down, my friends. Just before that, you know, anybody here, you know, anybody here, if you have some any questions that you might want to ask, please leave it here in the comment box. I can answer your question right now at this point in time, be it in terms of buying rice, be it in terms of exporting rice, be it in terms of payment terms, be it in terms of supply chain delivery, be it in terms of packaging. You know, please, if you have any questions, please leave it in the comment box here, which I can reply to you right now, right? So I was coming to this you know, question of, if you have to expand your rice business, you will have to add more rice to your you know, basket. You will have to offer more rice. I will tell you why. Because if your customer is a retail shop, you are a wholesaler of rice, and your customers are retail or supermarkets or, you know, kirana shops in your area, they will want Sona Masuri rice, they will want basmati rice, they will want broken rice, they will want idli rice, they will want dosa rice. Say, let's minimum 5 types of rice. The idli rice, you can buy it from, you know, Arani Kanchipuram in Tamil Nadu. Sona Masuri rice, you can buy it from Tumkur, Raichur, Bellari, these kind of regions. Basmati rice, you can buy it from Punjab, Muksar in Punjab, Karnal in Haryana, right? If you want dosa rice, it is normally IR64 and Swarna, which is from Nagpur or Chhattisgarh. So how do you even buy from multiple places? How do you track the prices? Whom do you get in touch with? Can you buy directly from millers? All for all this question, there is only one answer, my friends. PWIP, which you know, has a great service. I'm going to show it on my smartphone. So this is how a PWIP you know, logo looks like. Here is the mobile number. I don't know if you are able to see it very clearly. I'm trying to show it here. I'm going to read out this number for you. It is 83177-49274. 83177-49274. You just have to save this number and just send a hi. That's it. Your job is done. So any point in the time, anywhere in the world you are, your importer, you want to see prices in US dollars, it will show you in US dollars. To this number, so this is the logo, identify this logo, my friends. Again, I'm going to note the number for you. It is 83177-49274. So just send a hi message, and then you can type 1 for basmati, type 2 for non-basmati, and then it'll ask you where do you want to see the rice from, whether you want to see it from Raichur in Karnataka, Telangana, Andhra, Chhattisgarh, Miryalguda, a lot of places. Is the number. So 83177-83177-49274, right? So I have a question coming here from one of the viewers. He's called Jayavardhan Babu. So thank you so much, sir, for writing in. The question here is, you know, I am planning to do rice export business. I want to know product knowledge before, where I'll get product knowledge, sir. So Jayavardhan Babu is asking for, he wants to do rice export business. First of all, my friends, whoever wants to get into exports, rice exports, you know, I would say that, you know, rice exports is the easiest and the best way of going getting into the business, because the benefits that rice export business can give you cannot you even get it in the local you know business. I'll tell you why, right? When you're into a trade where, you know, where you're buying rice and supplying rice to, supplying rice, when you supply, your payment, buyer might have told you he's going to buy from, in say he's going to pay you in, say, 15 days or 20 days. Right. So when but you know, customer might say, no, I will give it tomorrow, and then might be you might get the money, say, 1 week later, for example, right? But in export business, your payment whole thing is dependent on your BL copy, the bill of lading. Once your consignment is on board into a ship, you get a BL in hand, you will have to, you know, either click a picture or, you know, send a scan copy to your buyer in any country, and he will make the payment first, and only then will you release the truck. I have made a whole video around this on last Saturday. And my friends, you can search for PWIP on YouTube. There are about 40 plus videos on YouTube which you can refer to, where, you know, you can how to do rice exports, you know, or how to get into rice exports, how to do pricing in US dollars. All these things are given there in the YouTube channel as well, right? So here today's video is listening to about more about rice, how to reduce the price, how to moisture, how to reduce the price by increasing the broken percentage, and how to reduce the price by paying on loading or advance payment to the miller. I have one question coming here, my friends, which says it is Nikhil Cobra Gade. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing it wrong. Nikhil Cobra Gade. Hello, sir. I am rice miller from Chandrapur, Maharashtra. What's the scope of listing our rice brand on e-commerce platform? We make Kolam rice. So very nice question. A lot of times what happens is rice millers have a lot of rice brands, and sometimes they are able to give better pricing than the market. To Nikhil, I would suggest is that I hope you are using the PWIP's WhatsApp platform. The number is 8317749274. So this is the WhatsApp number where you can list yourself and you can do a lot of things. My friends, I would like to show you something which PWIP is coming up with very soon. So where millers can list themselves, and the idea here is to just on WhatsApp, without downloading any app, you can still get in touch with millers. You can still look for millers. So I'm going to quickly show you, my friends, as to how a miller's this would look, right? I'm again going to PWIP where you can look at the rice miller profiles there, and very easily you can see who is the miller, what is the name of the miller, what is the name of the mill, and what is the what all rice does he do, and what all mills that is mills, what all rice he mills, and what all brand he has is also there, my friends. So I'm going to quickly, I don't know whether the clarity is very clear, but I can quickly show you one, for example, there is, I'm going to show you this rice. His name is called Gautam. I hope you are able to see, my friends. I'm trying to show this on the camera. So this is Gautam from rice mill called Shriya Rice Mill, from a region called Raichur. He mills. I'm going to see for this first, and then I'm going to tell you. So it's Gautam from Shriya Mill, Raichur in Karnataka. He has a range of boiled rice, Sona half boiled rice, Sona full boiled rice, and R&R boiled rice. And he has five brands. One is called Arambangam Jungle brand, Shriya Rice Mix, green leaf, and Tiger Gold. So
This is how Gautam from I hope you're able to see my friends. This is how Gautam's profile. This can be seen on WhatsApp. So the answer to Mr. Nikhil from Chandrapur is that I think you should definitely get in touch with 83 our number 831-77-49274, where you can talk to the team there, and you can list yourself like this. So here in this profiles of a rice miller on WhatsApp, what all you get to know? So you get to know this is Gautam. This is his name, Gautam. He's from Shriya Rice Mill in Raichur in Karnataka. His mobile number is here, and then the rice that he does is here. I'm just trying to show you the brands he does is here. These are the five brands he does. So very, very nice miller who has talked to us personally, whom we are helping to connect with buyers like you. So I understand that there are a lot of people who are also abroad outside India trying to, who buy rice on a regular basis. You on this platform, you can see rice prices in US dollars as well. So I think these are the questions that have come till now. So the Parthiban SL, thanks for sending in a message. There is some Bakhtiyar Madhya, very informative. So thank you so much. Then there is Jayavardhan Babu. We got in touch with Mr. Vishwa here. Vishwak here. Thank you so much, Nikhil. And then we have one more question. To avoid credit, miller can also be retailer. Yes, milling is a totally different 100% focus is required. Milling has to be done. If you have to become a retailer also, it is a new business, because in the retail shop you are not only going to sell rice. There has to be hundreds of items, other items that has to be sold, for that when customer comes in, he's able to see your he buy other products as well for his house. So that becomes a different ball game altogether. Bakhtiyar Madhya is asking, how can you help me export rice for the first time from procuring to export? To Mr. Bakhtiyar, my answer would be that we do talk and help businesses to become first time export. I would suggest you two things. Firstly is to Google, search for PWIP on YouTube. PWIP has a whole channel on YouTube where there are 40 plus videos, and then there is a series of videos on YouTube which is specifically to become an exporter. How to prepare documentation, how to identify a customer, how to identify a customer is authentic or fake, how to do documentation, how to do pricing in US dollars. What about shipping? What about documentation? What about payment terms? All this is given on the PIP's YouTube channel. And plus, you can get in touch with our number 831-77-49274, where we do really also help users to become rice exporters. So this is the topic for today, my friends. So I would like to summarize my video for today. Thank you so much for your participation. I would like to end this video with the three important points that we discussed as to how can we bring down the rice prices. One is through moisture. If a 12% moisture is lesser in price than a rice which is dried at 10% moisture. So you can understand the moisture from the miller and bring down the price. The second one is a broken percentage. If your broken percentage is 5% and your broken percentage is 10%, the prices of 10% broken will be much lesser than a 5% broken, right? So through broken. And the last one is through your finances. So if you are paying onloading or in advance, you just tell your prices, tell your price to your miller. He will advise you, he or she will advise you whether he can do it at that price or not. Because that particular miller, it is on a case-to-case basis. He will take a decision whether he can do it for that price, or he will give you a counter offer. So if the market it has to, a market is at 2900, he can even do it at even 2700 or 2800, depending on the miller, right? So when you have the power of finance, you can you have also the bargaining power, which is a good thing, because millers also will be looking for faster payment cycles, and then you can also improve your pricing, and you can sell it at a better price to your buyer. You know, these are things that you can do. So every Saturday, my friends, we will try to come online to help with any queries related to rice business, selecting rice and rice exports. So thank you so much, friends. Hoping to see you again soon. Thank you. Thank you so much.